Is she back? That is the question today that some are asking about Vishojo's Henya, self-described as a super genius with the IQ of 999, now set to debut on May 13th at 9 p.m. Pacific. Along with her YouTube channel being created back on April 3rd, this new member of Vishojo has taken to Twitter and posting in two languages, English and Japanese, posting up her full lore video on YouTube and being welcomed by other Vishojo members like Project Melody, possibly calling Henya flat right here, responding to Zentreya with Ramen Ramen, along with responding to Fruit, Haruka, and Iron Mouse with what is to some a very familiar arigato. Speaking today on that member is Iron Mouse. Let's take a listen.
Honest question about Henya. Is he a part of the JP branch or the N branch?
Henya is a hybrid
also
member.
Happy Friday.
A part of both JP and EN branch. She is the bridge. She is a bridge between both branches.
So here we have this bilingual VTuber joining as a bridge. Once again, leading many to wonder if we have possibly heard of this VTuber before, but from a past life as a previous VTuber, not affiliated with Vishojo at that time. Feel free to leave your speculation and thoughts below, as once again, this VTuber is debuting on Saturday, May 13th at 9 p.m. Pacific, Sunday at midnight Eastern. And what's next for Vishojo?
Yeah, we have a new family member coming. And then, I don't know, maybe we'll have even more family members coming. We'll have even more members coming soon. I don't know. I know Kason said that there was more people coming. I also know that there's people coming. Can't tell you who they are, though. Oh, they're coming. They're coming, all right.
And now, next up, we turn to Niji Sanji English's Ike Eveland, who has not streamed for 5 days now on his own channel, and now taking to Twitter this morning to explain, "Sorry I've been so quiet this week and sort of MIA." That being missing in action. I usually don't like talking about personal stuff a whole lot, but without getting into more detail than needed, it's been a rough week mentally. I sort of just checked out of reality and shut myself off from the world. I will probably use the rest of the week to focus on my behind-the-scenes obligations and pulling myself together. Again, I'm sorry for the radio silence, but I'll be around properly now. Let's make next week a much happier one together. Ike, of course, going on to receive support from his followers, as others would have suspicions, saying, "Who wants to bet that Niji Sanji did a quote, quiet suspension here?" And so any bets on what Ike got suspended for? Niji Sanji English right now having a little bit of problems with having their followers trust them, as in their very own notice about the termination of Zion Lanza, they did confirm stealth suspensions are a practice that they have within the branch. And now with further revelations by Zion, or the talent who was formerly Zion, confirming that reasons given for hiatuses are not always true, these questions may continue to linger as other members of Niji Sanji English do take breaks and vacations. And speaking of Sayu, she is now a YouTube partner, saying, "It already happened. What? You guys are the best. Thank you so much for this amazing new beginning. I'm so excited for all that we'll do together." Then putting up a waiting room for a Sunday Q&A to celebrate the YouTube partnership. And next, we turn to the parent company of Niji Sanji, AnyColor, now giving us this alert, stating, "We have received a report that a scam has been reported to our company, in which a person has been scammed out of money in the name of one of our company's performers." This alert continuing on, "A person claiming to be a member of our group has defrauded a third party of money. Our company's related persons, including our own performers, do not demand money from people with whom we do not have a business relationship. In the unlikely event that you receive a similar contact from a person or social media account claiming to be a performer, employee, or other person associated with our company asking for money, please do not respond to the request, but report it to our company or the police." And also with Niji Sanji, we have Zaya, set to graduate this Sunday, May 14th. This liver taking to Twitter to say, "Thank you so much for today. Having 3 streams a day has never felt so satisfying before. I enjoyed every single moment. I love everyone so much. They're all so nice to me." We'll have more about that graduation in our next episode, as we turn back to this merchandise mentioned in our last episode. Niji Sanji English asking, "Ready to grab special merch of your ocean? Yoshi, with some of this merch being rubber keychains. Well, as it turns out, we have a little bit of an error, as the fan name on this rubber keychain for their talent Renzotto is seen here spelled with an S, when in actuality, it is supposed to be spelled with a Z. Nijisanji then updating due to an error, fan name rubber keychain Renzotto product design and shipping schedule have been updated. We apologize for the inconvenience caused and thank you for your understanding. And that's right, it's been 2 years of Nijisanji English. And further to celebrate alongside with that, we have Lazulite's second single, Light Me Up, being released on May 16th. Also celebrating today was me. Hold on, wait, no, again, not me, Habari. Now releasing his first original song, Skylark. And earlier today, debuting in 3D to an audience of 110,000 live viewers. Fantastic reviews of this 3D debut all around, as also joining him on stage was Inoue Toko of Nornis, this being a three-member team from Nijisanji, with Nornis now releasing their performance of Goodbye Myself for free from their recent first live concert. This all, of course, available on YouTube.com. And now it's finally time to talk about it. The game release that will clearly be the game of the year. That's right, it's Idol Showdown, the Hololive fighting game. A free Hololive fighting game created by fans for fans and available on Steam. And giving us a proper review of this game is Maximilian Dude, fighting game enthusiast and VTuber expert.
I'm trying to turn this light on behind me, chat. And then we're gonna, you know, turn on this game, which everybody and their mother's, nephew's, cousin's former roommate has been telling me to try. Fine, I'll do it. I've always been a extremely huge hologram virtual tubist, right? I'm extremely big, like mega sized, right? Super sized hologram virtual tubist, and a huge fan of the hologram virtual tubist library and its accompanying members. It's weirdly fun. Yeah, it's weirdly fun. This, it's GGPO, okay. So this free-to-play parody fighting holo VTuber game is about as feature-rich as the majority of fighting games released from 2000 to the late 2010s. And it's free. All right, what is the... She flips you off.
And of course, the FGC would not be the FGC if they were not toxic. The news of this game's release receiving such comments like, we will not be buying, even though it is free. While others would point out, Hololive fan game got rollback netcode before Dragon Ball FighterZ did. And we even have leaks, as officially here is a leaked stage in the files, with Kabuki catching Suisei outside. The game itself leading to loads of art from Keen Biscuit, and also Das Doctor giving us this Let's Go Iris. Idol Showdown letting us know that the full OST album is out now on YouTube, and that the game itself has now been downloaded over 500,000 times. And also, plenty of Hololive members have also been involved in the game or are playing the game, as during a stream with both Ninamai Inanis and Mori Calliope of Hololive English, the idea of inviting someone who knows fighting games to commentate on an Idol Showdown tournament was brought up. One of those names getting thrown into the ring being Coefficient, a fighting game and VTuber lover.
What did she say?
Stating, I will drop everything I do to give Max a 2.5 hour lecture of the shiz show that is the Hololive rabbit hole. Saying further, never thought in a million years this would be happening with the FGC and Hololive fans meeting together.
What? Oh, wait, what? Also, so, wait, what? Wasn't big a fan of VTubers before, but now I might check them out. Coco's my favorite so far, waiting for her next stream.
Coefficient being very busy in the last 12 hours especially, hosting yet another episode of In the Hole and bringing on a very special guest, that being Hololive Indonesia's Crazy Ollie, taking to Twitch in a very uncensored manner, with the two talking about feet, as Ollie's also set up to have an exclusive meet and greet at the now opened 3rd Anniversary Cafe. The opening of this event leading to tons of photos out there on Twitter, Meriwether also seeing these, and saying I wanted to get their merch so badly, but it was all sold sold out, Ollie then replying, "Take the windows! For legal reasons, this is a joke." And Ollie would not only talk about Idol Showdown with Coefficient, but also her upcoming appearance in Holocure, as all the members of Hololive Indonesia are set to appear in the next update. Coefficient releasing a video today with the developer Heyu, as Holocure has now released this very serious-looking statement. Reading out to our Holocure players, thank you very much for your generous support all this time for our game that we have been developing for the past long year. Holocure began development, yada yada yada, it's been truly a wild ride, blah blah blah. However, today, we'd like to talk about the future of Holocure due to some recent circumstances. We apologize and understand if some may find the following news upsetting. As you may know, we recently took down the Holocure game launcher, which was a quick way for players to update the game without needing to visit the webpage to re-download. While we cannot explain the circumstances of the takedown, it was an unforeseen problem, and ultimately we were not able to resolve it. Due to this, the ease of use of the game has suffered. As a different solution, we would like to announce some future changes to Holocure. We are very excited to announce, after discussing with official staff from Cover Corporation, that we are allowed to publish Holocure on Steam, continuing there as an unofficial free fan game. Our contact with Cover Corporation began some months ago, and since then have made sure there would be no problems regarding this matter. We apologize for taking so long. Therefore, moving forward, Steam will be the primary platform for Holocure, and future updates, the Steam release of Holocure will coincide with the release of Update 0.6 when it is ready. Until then, we hope you look forward to the Steam release of Holocure. Adding additional notes, Holocure will continue to be updated on itch.io. Your save file will not be lost upon moving over to Steam. And the statement is intentionally written to appear scarier than it actually is. We apologize for the inconvenience. KU then crediting David Wu for giving them the idea to announce it this way. Adding further, just wanted to say thank you personally to the Cover staff that I've spoken with that helped us with the various matters. They have been extremely pleasant to talk to and work with. Who knows what else may be in store for the future for us. So once again, Holocure coming to Steam and Idol Showdown currently available for Steam, both for free. We do have other announcements directly from Hololive, including an update about their Hololive English concert, the HoloEN Connect event. That taking place in Los Angeles on July 2nd, and now inviting Tokino Sora, Hoshimashi Suisei, and Hosho Marine as guests, and now announcing merch, including a tapestry snapback cap, shoulder bag, keychains, and acrylic stands. Further, we have official sponsors, that being Height and Omocat, coming to us with a keycap set and desk pad. Height personally saying big thank you to the Height and Hololive community for the overwhelming support of this bundle drop announcement. And that's not all for collabs, as finally, Valkyrie Connect has released all four of the new Hololive heroes, confirming Hosho Marine, Nanashi Mume, Sakamoto Chloe, and Oro Crony, changing her banner here with artwork from both Mume and Series Fauna. Crony saying of this announcement, I am looking respectfully, as others would notice a disparity in the artwork for the game versus the official artwork. Ari saying, who are you and what did you do to these? Crony also taking to Twitter to give us a very important message. Let's take a listen.
Have you ever had a dream that you want you had, you would, you could, you do, you would, you want you could do some you'll do, you could, you want to do so much? You ever have that kind of dream?
Okay, well now it's back to V Shoujo once again with Iron Mouse, teasing us once again, as last week we had the release of her long-awaited Ice Shaker from Advanced GG, only 1,000 originally in stock. The artwork seen here, as provided by Sushi Dog, saying thank you Iron Mouse for trusting me with the Advanced GG Ice Shaker design. Those 1,000 Ice Shakers would sell out in hours. Iron Mouse announcing later, we got more Shakers, thank you everyone for selling out my previous one, get them now. These Ice Shakers available in both pink and black. And once again, available on Advanced GG, we also have the False ID starter kits, and you can use code FALSE for 10% off your Advanced GG orders. Check it out with the link below, as finally, 1080p Iron Mouse is back. Mouse taking Twitter to say, OMG, finally internet, the fastest speeds I have ever seen in my life. Dude, I literally clicked download and things instantly downloaded. How is this real life? Also giving a plug here, my Ironside PC is an absolute beast. How did I live before? As next, the Off-Kai Expo, self-described as a VTuber convention, are pumped to announce V Shoujo as the sponsor of Off-Kai Cafe. This event taking place between June 16th and 18th. And on display here, we have, of course, Mouse, along Haruka Caribou, and V Shoujo's Zentrea. V Shoujo letting us know the Maid Cafe's standees will be available for purchase at Off-Kai and through their online store. Zentrea today taking part in a Fall Guys tournament alongside other VTubers. This particular Twitch Rivals event having a $50,000 pot, as now we also have the big reveal from Zen. She's partnering with U2's, saying they brought out the best quality of me, my big smile. A toaster cyborg for each of you to display, don't put near Roombas. This U2's figure dropping on May 20th at 3 p.m. Eastern, noon Pacific. That has officially announced Zentraya and Iron Mouse are not only taking part in Off-Kai, but also later this month, MomoCon. But while Iron Mouse was a part of the V-Shojo update on Smite, unfortunately Zentraya was nowhere to be seen. The Cyberpunk taking to Twitter to say, I know quite a few of you were asking about the Smite collab and what happened. Sadly, plans changed behind the scenes and unfortunately things had to be cut. Please don't give anyone a hard time. There will always be more opportunities for me in the future. Much love.
Hoping you'd be in it, but excited nonetheless.
Let's just say some things didn't exactly pan out. And things kind of just... well, I don't even know how to put this. It wasn't on our side, it was on their side. And they didn't plan appropriately so.
But Zentraya did make an appearance in something else recently, that alongside V-Shojo's Fruit, who was a part of the Smite collab, but also a part of another collab that alongside Obi Katie Cat, releasing a brand new cover song and music video, the two holding an after party, getting plastered on a Friday night like good old Brits, this all after Katie Cat's recent re-debut, complete with this 3D outfit commission from Rika, our very own 3D modeler for all of TVS. Fruit also getting that check mark of a verified artist, alongside the cover artwork that from Kamo. As Fruit would comment, Kamo did such an awesome job. I love this art so much. And even providing the original rough sketch, stating I love giving artists my awful doodle drafts because the result is exactly what I asked for and more. And next up, we have the cooking VTuber, Geary, now confirmed to be attending Anime North 2023, saying, we're back, baby. Thank you, Anime North, for inviting me back this year. I'm pumped to hang out with everyone again, as Geary has been on a whirlwind of collabs that alongside Crazy Ollie, Mika Melatika, and Fillion, now also promising a brand new Oni Mart announcement on May 13th at 10:30 a.m. Eastern, 7:30 a.m. Pacific. And further along, we have Sender, the Hellhound Wolf VTuber, now celebrating an astonishing 100,000 followers on Twitch.tv and collecting them all. That's right, all of the VTuber plushies, including her own. As right now on makeshift.com, at the time of this recording, there is still one day left to purchase a Hellhound Wolf plush. It's currently over 600 have been sold. And further, we are back with Idol, this VTuber agency celebrating their 1 year anniversary alongside their origin talents and dropping numerous teasers for their next talents to hashtag IdolEN2, giving us the date of May 31st and promising a brand new trailer alongside these silhouettes, saying to this one, watch your belongings for a clever thief is among us. Another silhouette stating it's getting hot in here. This silhouette posted with soundcheck 1-2, tune in, the show's about to begin. And a fourth silhouette, once again promising the reveal trailer, as we are expecting one more silhouette teaser. And lastly, also being teased, we have this announcement from Phase Connect saying, let's go down the VTuber rabbit hole together, and now promising even more Phase Invaders alongside the date of May 2023. And that's not all, as we have even more things VTubers say alongside Cody. Take it away.
Ko-hi-yo. Cover have spent around $20 million in the last year and a half in order to build one of Japan's largest motion capture studios. The studio is the size of more than 10 tennis courts and contains not only a motion capture studio, but a chroma key studio and two recording studios, allowing creators to record all the content needed on one floor. And while some studios may have more than 100 motion capture cameras, Cover Corp Studio contains over 200 of the latest units, resulting in the ability to shoot more delicate motions, such as fingers and facial expressions. And it is able to perform precise calculations, even with multiple people. Each studio has its own control room, and the chroma key studio is attached to the main motion one, allowing for special shots, such as augmented reality and live action compositioning. Additionally, each studio is also equipped with both a waiting room and a powder room. Yago tweeted, we've opened a new studio to provide cutting edge 2D entertainment from Japan, and we're looking to hire staff. But it's not just the studio who got an upgrade, as Cover has teamed up with Sony to distribute Time of Flight AR to its talents. The new software allows for face and hand tracking to be captured easily from one smartphone. In more entertainment news, we check out the elite idol Sakura Miko, who posted this video giving us an insight of what it's like to wake up with her in the morning.
Sonia.
and recently covered Kyofu Orubaku or Strong Wind All Back. The MV, which features Suisei and was created by Yusha, has come in like a tornado, gaining views incredibly fast. Miko has been posting art alongside the milestones, starting with 350k view celebration, 570k views, 800k views, 1 million, 1.4 million, 1.6 million, and then hitting 2 milli in less than a week. The popularity of the cover has led to many bits of artwork, such as this one by Hyde, who captured Miko fighting against the winds. Luck, showing Suisei going against the winds. Sabaku, capturing a woman who can't be stopped by the strong winds. And Milk Tea with, oh, Hoshimachi Suisei is also celebrating milestones again, as she hits 1.3 million followers on Twitter, and also gave us a little behind the scenes at her new role as MC for NHK's VTuber Radio. But Suisei has also been announced as one of the three surprise guests to the highly anticipated Hololive English live concert, taking place in the YouTube Theater in LA. She joins fellow JP talent Tokina Sora, Hosho Marine, as well as Indonesia talent Muna, Risu, and Rene, who were announced last week. And although tickets for the concert almost immediately sold out, there will be a second distribution happening on May 13th at 10 a.m. PDT. Suisei went on to tweet, "I'll work together to do my best. Looking forward to meeting everyone overseas." She later announced a brand new cover of Ikizama, adding, "I covered a song I fell in love with at first sight. The mix was done by the song's author, Natsumi Chiaki." Last week, Sui announced that due to various reasons, it's going to be difficult to stream in the first half of May, and asked fans to wait for the second half of May. Since then, she has updated everyone with a new tweet, letting us know that she'll be taking a break from being a streamer to be a lyricist, designer, and planner, but also stating that being a VTuber is fun. In other news, we take a look at the Fennec Fox Omaru Polka, who this week held a stream teasing a new hairstyle, which was revealed to be a short haired polka and a brand new headset. She tweeted, "This is the simplest Polka-chan yet, and here's photo evidence." Fellow Fox Shirakami Fubuki tweeted her love for the new do, and also tweeted that she went to Osaka Comic Con during Golden Week, saying, "I've been planning to go for a few months and experience it with the family. Mom and dad are geeks too, so it is great to have fun with them." She also tweeted a photo with Mads Mikkelsen, saying it was a memory of a lifetime. Wait, is that Mads Mikkelsen doing the hover hand? Ayunda Risu saw the photo and tweeted, "If Fubuki can take a picture with Mads Mikkelsen, I want a picture with Keanu Reeves one day." Shirakami Fubuki's figures are also now available from Good Smile US. Lastly, we check in with Hololive staff A-chan, who asked, "How do you say Haishin no Waku o Tateru in English?" Which roughly translates to set up a stream, or in YouTube terms, setting up a waiting room. One of the JP bros translated it to setting up the delivery frame, as A-chan went on to ask the Kagai Nikkis, tweeting, "There are some answers that say frame the delivery, but I've never heard of it. Does it sound natural to you?" Another user replied with, "Some believe it's called waiting room, although the delivery is the stream." A-chan tweeted, "I wonder why it's translated to delivery. And honestly, we've always thought that was weird." A-chan also posted some new assets, where of course fans have started using it in the best way possible, such as this Aqua version and this. Reiruka did post their own slower version of it, as Hololive Indonesia's Kareji Oli commented with brutal. But that's everything from me. Back over to you, Fulse.
Thank you very much, Cody. And we have another co-host with us today. Yes, that's right. It's Heidi, bringing us even more agency VTuber news.
Hi, everyone. Starting off, we check in with VTuber agency Polygon Official as they announced their Polygon High School special event, providing a thread detailing the scheduled activities for the agency, or rather the Prime Lumine Guardian High School, playing into the school theme as they hold their event period as a fun and eventful academic semester, beginning with the special live stream events occurring every Friday throughout the event period, from May 19th all the way to June 16th, with events such as a test of courage, a final exam, a sports day, and a cultural festival day. Though all streams of this event period will seemingly be divided into four different categories or areas of study to further fit the school theme, those categories being academic, social and literature, physical education, and arts and music. And even you can be a part of the PLG school event too, as Polygon hopes to invite the community by providing themed assets, which you can use to show off your school identity and or story as you follow along through the semester with a hashtag PLGHS event. But even though Polygon's second generation had made their debut with this school theme, they won't be the only talents who will be members of the Prime Lumine Guardian High School, as Polygon shares with us that the talents of their first generation will also be given updated school profiles as well. making this an event for the whole agency to participate in, and for you to participate in too. I'm really not kidding about it. You can literally vote now for which student talent will be the head of Prime Lumine Guardian High School. Each of these six running candidates even have a policy video stream on why you should vote for them on their respective YouTube channels. And that's still not all for participation, as there is even a soon-to-be fan art contest for fans and artists to draw the talents within the theme of high school daily situation and win prizes, with more details coming out soon. And to wrap up this high school event is some special merchandise themed accordingly to the occasion, and with the pre-order period starting from now, May 12th, all the way to June 18th. But the school-themed content doesn't stop there, as we lastly check in with Prism Project's Nan Anan, who, along with fellow talent Iku Hoshifuri, has been working on a video film series project titled Prism High, a reality TV-inspired mini storytelling adventure about Nan and Iku's friendship, set to have a total of 4 weekly episodes, and even featuring their other fellow talents as narrators, as well as the two hoping to release a mystery cover at the end of the series. Episode 1 is already released on Nan's channel, and the second episode is set to premiere tomorrow, May 13th, on Iku's channel, so be sure not to miss it. That's all for me. Back to you, False.
Thank you so much, Heidi. And she's got to go fast. That's right. It's Heidi and her Oshi, Sonic the Hedgehog, together at last. As Nika Miura would give us, I've been waiting to draw her in a Sonic onesie for a while now. This turned out just as cute as I imagined. And that is all for this episode. As always, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe below. Send in your VTuber news to our Discord. We record live on Twitch.tv, and we'll have more Things VTubers Say for you soon.